From the Library of Congress in Washington, D.C.
Good evening, and welcome to the opening concert of the second half of the 2010-11 season. I think you'll find that it will really be a stellar spring season. We have some true high spots in several genres, including classical, jazz, and American roots. In April and May, we'll present a new music mini festival that will feature the world premieres of library commissions. In other words, we've commissioned these by two important American composers, Sebastian Currier and Stephen Hartke. Both composers will be here, actually, and talk about their new works. In addition, George Crumb will also be here for a special evening with the Chamber Music Society from Lincoln Center. You can also hear three jazz concerts with major artists admired around the world, Eddie Daniels, Roger Kellaway, Brad Meldow, and the legendary Marshall Solow. So please do join us at here and at the Atlas Performing Arts Center. For this next piece, I'd like it to get a little bit quiet. I can't end this introduction tonight without paying a homage to one of our founding patrons, Gertrude Clark Whittle. Her gifts made possible not only the Whittle Pavilion and our wonderful Stradivari instruments, but also a large collection of important manuscripts. And one of them is featured here tonight, Schoenberg's original manuscript for Verklärte Nacht is one of these manuscripts. It's on display this evening in the foyer, so please take a minute to have a look at it. In July 1950, Mrs. Whittle donated the funds that enabled us to purchase four important items: the holograph music manuscript for Schoenberg's Verklärte Nacht, Pierre Lunar, and his second string quartet, as well as the manuscript for the Mendelssohn Octet. You can see why we loved her. And the reason that I invoke her name tonight stems from our program. The Salzburg Hyperion Ensemble brings us a concert from Vienna centered on Arnold Schoenberg's string sextet, Verkl Nacht. This work is special for us not only because Mrs. Whittle purchased it for us, but because she loved it so much. At the concert given in this auditorium, October 7th, 1965, as a memorial to her, L. Quincy Mumford, who then was the librarian of concert, ended his remarks with the following quotation. She loved Schoenberg's Transfigured Night. Its passionate phrases transfigure this night for us and put us en rapport with the lovely lady whose spirit resides here always. And the quote continues, Mrs. Whittle often said, when I'm gone, if you play Transfigured Night, I'll come back. We're playing it now and shall play it many times in the future, but not to summon her back, for she never departed. Enjoy the evening.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, I may introduce the new member in our ensemble, Susanne von Gutzeit, instead of Gregor Siegel.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
This has been a presentation of the Library of Congress. Visit us at loc.gov.